don't expire is the word of God. It's forever. Power expires. There were billionaires of yesterday that their children are suffering today. Be careful what you do. Why will you give your enemy advantage and be disadvantaged in the issues of life?
Liberation glory.
You showed you can.
Take your Bible. I want to share something very important with you. When your spiritual life starts going down, it will not be long. Every other thing in your life will be affected. Once your spiritual life, because your spiritual life is the engine room. Is the engine room of everything around you, your spiritual life. Once your spiritual life is affected, listen carefully. Once your spiritual life is affected, every other area in your life,
dans votre vie,
it will not take time. Every area, when I mean every area,
le temps, je dis tout côté de votre vie,
will be affected.
Seront aussi dérangés.
And the first thing to know that your spiritual life is affected, is down, that you are in serious problem, is when you begin to lose your prayer life.
Vous commencez à perdre votre vie spirituelle.
When prayer is no longer fanciful,
lorsque la prière n'est pas,
you don't fancy to pray anymore.
Régulière, vous ne priez plus.
You don't see it as anything.
Ne vois pas ça comme quelque chose.
To pray becomes so difficult.
Ça devient difficile.
That's the greatest attack you can receive.
C'est l'attaque la plus grande que vous
pouvez. The enemy wants to attack you.
L'ennemi veut vous attaquer.
He attack your life of prayer. He attack your life of fasting. You can't pray. You can't fast anymore.
Vous ne pouvez pas prier.
You know what happens? Just know that you are gone.
Vous savez que vous êtes en regret.
And this is the reason why some people will come to church and forget their Bible in the church.
Les gens vont venir à l'église et oublient leur Bible dans l'église.
Is a sign of a spiritual kwashioko.
And
amen, somebody.
Amen.
So when you see people come to church,
lorsque vous voyez les gens venir à l'église,
and every now and then,
et d'ici là,
ushers are going about picking things. You see a lot of Bible.
Les gens vont ramasser les Bibles et les choses.
You come to church and you forget your Bible.
À l'église, vous oubliez votre Bible.
Is a very big problem.
C'est un grand problème.
It's an indication that your spiritual life is going down.
En train de régresser.
And let me repeat this again.
Je répète ça encore.
The biggest attack on the life of anybody
dans la vie de toute personne.
Is attack on your prayer life.
L'attaque sur votre point de prière.
Once your prayer life is under attack, that's the real attack.
C'est l'attaque réelle.
The real attack is not your finance.
C'est pas vos finances.
Yeah. There is the one that has power to give wealth. I am the Lord that God has given the power to make wealth. If you can call upon that one for assistance, you can climb up again. But when everything is gone, you finish. Psalm 65 and verse 2. O thou that hearest prayer, unto thee shall all flesh come. Unto thee shall all flesh come. Unto thee. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. In Jesus' name. Please be seated. And in Luke chapter number 11. And it came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray as John also taught his disciples. Verse 2. And he said unto them, when ye pray, say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, and thy will be done on earth. Thy will be done on earth. Another translation says, as it is in heaven. Then it says, give us this day Give us what? This day. Our what?
Notre
daily
quoi?
Bread.
Notre pain quotidien.
Now let me stop there.
Okay, m'arrête là.
The Bible said Jesus went to a certain place to pray.
Dans une place pour prier.
I'm speaking to you briefly. Why everybody must pray?
La raison pour laquelle tout le monde doit.
Not some people. Everybody, every child of God, every believer.
Tout croyant.
He went to a certain place to pray.
Dans une certaine place pour prier.
And the disciples.
Les disciples là.
Who have been with him,
avec lui,
who understand that prayer
la prière,
is become his lifestyle.
Ça devient leur vie.
Prayer is part of his tradition,
part de leur tradition
and part of his custom.
Partie de leur coutume.
Then,
alors,
having studied Jesus, doing the same thing again and again. What someone does again and again is the person's lifestyle. Lifestyle is what you are used to, what you do again and again. Amen, somebody. So the Bible said, the disciples came to him. They said, Master, we have observed your patterns of prayer. How is it that you are a man of prayer? Master, teach us how to pray. Teach us how to pray. Now take note of this. You can't pray because you hear people praying. Oftentimes, one of the biggest problems in Christendom is that everybody come to church. When you give your life to Jesus Christ, in so many churches, they just tell you one of the things you need to do. You read your Bible and be prayerful. How can somebody pray or be prayerful when the person does not even know how to pray? And again, how can somebody pray when their prayers are not producing results? The Bible says you pray, but you pray amiss. That means you don't just pray. Okay, you say somebody go and pray.
Allez prier.
Do you know that?
Vous savez que
everybody prays. Are you aware?
Vous êtes au courant?
Christians pray.
Les chrétiens prient.
Muslims,
les musulmans,
they pray.
Prient.
The Hindus,
les Hindous.
The Buddhists,
les Bouddhistes.
The Shintos.
Jésus aussi prie.
The traditionalists, they all pray. Are you aware?
Les gens de tradition.
They pray.
Prie.
But the difference between us and them.
La différence entre nous.
Because you got to understand this before I go ahead. I'm trying to raise a little foundation. You got to understand something.
Devez comprendre quelque chose.
The Bible said there is a spirit in man.
Il y a un esprit en homme.
According to Job, he said it giveth it what inspiration.
Il donne l'inspiration.
There is a spirit in man, but it is the spirit of Elohim that giveth it inspiration. That means there is a spirit in man that can listen to spirits. And it is what you listen to, that is where you draw your inspiration from. Now, everybody, there is something in man that is seeking fellowship with a higher power, with a supernatural power. And but then, many people don't have the understanding of this. There is something in man that believes, that knows that there is a God somewhere or there is a power somewhere, but how to approach it is the problem. That's why Jesus said, no one cometh to the Father except by me. So thank God for Jesus who taught us. Thank God for Jesus who came and said, every other way is not the way. In other words, everybody is looking for way.
Tout le monde cherche les moyens.
Your grandfathers who went to worship idol, they saw that as the way.
Ils ont vu ça comme leur voie.
The ones who bow to the sun and the moon, they saw that as the way.
Non, vu ça comme ça, leur voix aussi.
But Jesus in John 14, 6, he says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one cometh to the Father except by me, except through me.
Except à travers.
So I am the doorway.
Je suis le portail.
You want to have fellowship with the Father? I am. Praise God. So everybody that serves God must serve Him in truth and in spirit. So when people come to church, they say pray, but they don't teach them how to pray. When you say be prayerful, the person even know what to be prayerful is? When the person kneels down, does the person even know what he or she is supposed to do?
La personne ne sait pas ce qu'il ou elle devait faire.
They say when a thing is not defined, abuse is inevitable. So people can actually pray and still be frustrated in the place of prayer because they don't understand. Now, first, God introduced Himself. He said, to him that answered prayer shall all flesh come. That means there is a system in the kingdom of how prayers are answered. And God says, I am the God that answered prayer, and unto me shall all flesh come. So we pray into the God, but through the name of Jesus.
Nous prions à Dieu, mais à travers le nom de Jésus.
So people pray
and
are frustrated in prayer. And there are people, when you tell them about prayer or when you call for prayer meeting, the reason why many churches, when you call for prayer meeting, the attendance is low. Because people say, why are we going to pray? What is the change? Why should we pray? The most important activity in the church is prayer. That's what Jesus said. He said, have you not heard that the house of my Father shall be called the house of prayer? He didn't say the house of praise and worship, the house of worship, the house of ushering or any other thing. The house of, he said the house of prayer. That's to say, when you talk about church, the most important activities in the church is prayer. So the disciples of Jesus didn't just go praying because they saw Jesus pray. They said, Master, teach us how to pray. You have to be taught how to pray. Then he said, when you pray, you say, our Father, who art in heaven. There are people who don't even understand the model of prayer Jesus taught. When you read Luke chapter 11 and read Matthew chapter 6, Jesus talking about the same our Lord's prayer. There was a model and there was a pattern. There was a way the prayer, Jesus modeled the prayer, and there was a pattern. And this prayer is powerful. He said, when you pray first, there are people who come to God and say, Father, today I've come again. Please give me money. Please give me money. Please prosper me, Lord. Please provide for me. No answer. Huh? Because the one who is the way shows you the key on how to assess him. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Hallowed be thy name. In other words, you don't approach the Father without giving him thanks. Thanksgiving is an application for more. So every time you give thanks to God, is a subtle way of saying, God, I need something. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thanksgiving is an application for more. So the Bible said the Lord God dwells in the praise of his people. So when you come before him first, say, Father, thank you.
D'abord, merci, Seigneur.
If not for any other thing, thank you that I'm alive.
Je suis en vie.
I don't care to know what else you have done or what else you have not done in my life. For the fact that I have life, I just want to say thank you.
Merci.
Give him thanks first. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Que votre nom soit sanctifié.
That's honor.
Et c'est l'honneur.
Then after that, thy kingdom come.
Votre royaume vienne.
Thy will be done on earth. Listen carefully. These are not just prayers. These are things that are enforced in the place of prayer and that must be reflective in your life by practically enforcing them. Listen carefully. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come and thy will be done on earth. Now, if the kingdom come, you work by the system of the kingdom. Then on earth, what does God want? He said, let the will of God be done. What is the will of God on earth? The will of God is above all things that you be in good and that you prosper, even as your soul does what? Prosper. Now, that will be done on earth. What is the will of God? The will of God on earth is that we take over the world for Him. When you pray and the will of God is not being enforced, you have prayed, but you are not enforcer of what you have prayed for. Because you are not a soul winner. You don't win soul, you don't talk to people. Part of the will of God on earth is that the kingdom of darkness be depopulated.
Yes, sir.
That will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Then give us this day our daily bread. You know why? God, the company of God, God is the only one that pays on daily basis. Even multi-billion naira companies or multi-billion dollars companies, they don't pay every day. Maybe they pay every 2 weeks or every month. But in the kingdom of God, in the system of the kingdom, it's every day. And why is it every day? It's a necessity that you must go to God every day for your daily release. Give us this day our daily bread. That bread does not entail only what you eat. The bread is a provision. The provision contains your everything about you, your security, your protection, your going out and your coming in, supernatural provision. That means the day you don't go to God in prayer, you have not worked that day. Hello? The day you have not gone to God, you did not go to Him because He gave you for yesterday when you pray. What about today? That means He wants fellowship with you in the place of prayer again and what? Again. Amen. Now I want to give you a few reasons, if I have time, why everyone must pray. Why? I know, I have a pastor, I have a prophet, my man of God prays for me. That's good. God wants your own. Yeah. God wants you to have daily time and hour of prayer. I know you are busy. I know you are the CEO of the whole world. No problem. But God still wants your time. Amen?
Amen.
Because in 24 hours of the day, you can't give 1 hour to God, something is wrong. If it's too difficult for you to do, why not get up at midnight or early in the morning and pray for 30 minutes? Then when you come back, before you go to bed, pray for 30 minutes. Again, because according to Matthew chapter 26, verse number 40.
Verse 14.
He said, at least the minimum we should pray.
The minimum, the prayer
is 1 hour.
C'est une heure.
How many? That you did not pray. At least you must pray for 1 hour.
Je prie au moins une heure du temps, par jour.
He said, and he cometh unto the disciples and findeth them asleep, and said unto Peter, what could ye not watch with me? How many hours? 1 hour. Jesus is saying, at least the minimum. This is Jesus. I'm not the one teaching this now. I'm referring you to Jesus. He says, at least 1 hour. 1 hour. How many hours?
1 hour.
I know you've heard of teachings about prayers. I know you know we're praying church and all that. But how many of you here pray?
Personnellement, pour une
at least 1 hour. Let me see your name. At least.
Je vois votre main en l'air.
At least. At least. At least.
Par jour.
Okay. I'm not seeing the hands. Let me see. At least 1 hour.
Il n'a pas vu les mains.
Okay. All right, put it down. How many of you wakes up at midnight to pray?
Combien d'entre vous se réveillez à minuit pour prier?
At least maybe 4 times a week.
4 fois dans la
semaine. 5 times a week.
5 fois dans la semaine.
Can I see? Those people stand up, let me see. At least 3 times a week. 4 times a week. Okay, sit down. We are making serious progress. Okay, number one reason.
La raison première.
Why everybody must pray. Listen. Prayer is important. It's not just for us alone. It's something that must be transcended to your children, to everyone around you. Now, when everybody begins to pray, what will happen? We will enjoy the presence of God as never before. We will see the power of God. We will see God in action as never before. Number one reason why we must pray is that prayer is a command.
La prière, c'est un commandement.
In Luke chapter number 18 and verse number 1,
dans Luc 18,
remember it says, men ought
les hommes
to pray and not faint. So,
ne pas cesser.
It's a command.
C'est un commandement.
And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not faint. In other words, prayer is a command.
Prière, c'est un commandement.
1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse number 17.
5, verset 17.
There is read another place where it shows us that prayer is a what? A command.
C'est un commandement.
Pray without ceasing.
Sans saison.
When you pray because you have a problem, you are not praying.
Parce que vous avez un problème, vous ne priez pas.
You don't pray because there is problem. You pray because it's part of your life.
Il faut prier parce que c'est une partie de votre vie.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
It's a command.
C'est un commandement.
So what happens when we pray every day, when we pray again and again, when we have time of prayer, a place of prayer, where we meet with God, where angels visit us when we pray, what happens? A man or a woman of prayer fight certain battles before the battles arrive.
Fait des batailles avant que la bataille n'arrive.
I hear you, sir.
Yeah, that's what your prayer. Your prayer fight battles ahead for you before the battles arrive.
Yes, sir.
Now, battles that are supposed to consume you. You enter the battle, but nobody knew how you came out of the battle. The battle wasn't fought that day. The battle was fought. Even before that time, you only saw the battle. The enemy expected you to die. He expected the battle to drown you, but you came out of the battle unscathed, better, victorious, and moving forward. Why? Because a prayer arrow was fired ahead of you.
Teach us something, sir.
The prayer arrow was fired.
Une flèche de prière qui était.
You know what your prayer is?
Vous voyez?
Your prayer is like a protocol.
Comme un gardien.
It goes ahead of you.
Ça va au-delà.
And where there is obstacle, where there is problem, he arranges it. Protocol things. Clears the way where it's necessary. Before you arrive that place, the way is already cleared. That's what your prayer does.
Ce que la prière fait.
So that's why you need to begin to pray today.
C'est pourquoi vous devez prier.
That's why it's necessary.
Parce que c'est nécessaire.
As you are praying into the future of your children. Because your prayers are being stored up. Now what happens when a rich man dies?
Lorsqu'un riche meurt,
they have so much money in their bank account, properties. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Who inherited? Who inherited those things?
Tu vas prendre les choses là.
Correct?
Ce sont des enfants.
Except the man has a will written and saying so person should be included, should take this and take that.
C'est
but then the children guess it.
Bon,
now, don't those things the children will inherit, did it came the day the man died?
No, sir.
It's something the man has worked for.
Over life.
The day will come, your children will inherit your prayers.
Revelation.
A day will come, your children, they are going to inherit your prayer. A day will come when your children will inherit your prayer. I'll show you as we go forward. So the reason why everybody must pray is that prayer is a command. If you are not praying, then you are disobeying God. You are working in disobedience if you are not praying. I don't care to know how busy you are. But the Bible says God loves Abraham because he will command his family. Every man must command their family in the place of prayer.
Chaque personne, toute personne doit commander leur famille sur la place de prière.
Number two reason.
La raison numéro deux
is for the sake of fellowship.
La prière.
Fellowship with the Holy Spirit.
Ensemble avec l'Esprit Saint.
Fellowship with the Holy Spirit. You know, the most powerful personality in the world is the Holy Spirit.
L'Esprit Saint.
So you can't be powerless when you are fellowshipping with the most powerful person in the world. You can't be powerless. So for the sake of fellowship, that means you are not working in this earth as a weakling. You are working because the most powerful spirit backs you up and works with you. And but the most powerful spirit does not come without you being deliberately in the place of prayer. Because Jesus said, I'm going, but when I go, I'm sending another spirit, another comforter. And I've said this again and again. You say, when some people, they say, oh, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And that means the Holy Spirit is the third in command. That's an insult. Your body, your soul, and your spirit is one. Holy Spirit is not the junior God. Holy Spirit is not the third in command. Holy Spirit is God himself. The Holy Spirit is the wisdom of God. The Holy Spirit is the revealer of the person and the presence of God. The Holy Spirit reveals the character of God. How can the spirit, the personality who plays such role, he says it's a junior God, it's an insult. That's why Jesus, he said, I'm sending another comforter. He didn't say a lesser comforter. He didn't say, that means Jesus equated the Holy Spirit as him. What's the difference between the Holy Spirit and Jesus? Jesus is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is Jesus. Jesus is the Holy Spirit, is the unlimited Jesus. The Holy Spirit is the unlimited Jesus. Why Jesus was on earth? Jesus was limited by his human body. Jesus was limited by his human body because he got the nature from his mother Mary. And as a human, he could not be in different places at the same time except in the spirit. But the Holy Ghost can be in all the countries of the world at the same time carrying out operation. So the Holy Ghost is the unlimited Jesus. So in the days of Jesus, in Jesus' ministry here on earth, Jesus could be in one location at a time. And they will say, let us cross over to the other side. But the Holy Ghost does not need to cross over to the other side. The Holy Ghost is already in the other side. Why do you need to have fellowship with the Spirit who is everywhere? The Spirit that is everywhere. Because anywhere the battle comes from, the Holy Spirit will fight for you. So how do you fellowship with the Holy Ghost? 1 Corinthians chapter number 14.
1 Corinthians chapter 14.
Verse number 2.
Verset 2.
If you are a child of God here today, you have not received the Holy Ghost, you are not speaking in tongues, It means you are powerless.
Ça veut dire que vous n'avez pas du pouvoir.
It also means you are a believer, but you are a believer without approval. You are a believer without a sign. You are a believer without approval. Do you know you can buy a car today without registration? Any security agency can arrest you on the way. The road safety can arrest you. The police can arrest you. Even the army, they say, where this car might be a stolen one. But when they, with registration number and everything, with your license, they stop you, you show them. A believer who does not speak in tongues is like a car that is not registered. This sign shall follow them that believe. In my name. Listen, this sign shall follow them that believe. In my name, they shall cast out demons.
Mon nom, ils vont renvoyer les démons.
They shall lay hands on the sick. They shall recover. They shall take up deadly poisons, and they shall by no means hurt them.
Ils vont prendre les...
And they shall speak.
Mortel, rien ne va les surpasser.
A new one. So these are the signs that follows a believer. Now what of a believer who has no sign?
Le croyant qui n'a pas de signe.
You are a believer, no doubt, but you don't have divine approval.
Le croyant, il y a pas de doute, mais vous n'avez pas la
Between now, not long, we're going to bring a day that will be for the school of the Holy Ghost. And get everyone that is not filled yet to be filled. So you can even be enjoying what we are talking about. Because when we are talking about this, you don't understand it. The Holy Ghost can direct you. Even in the place of confusion. The Holy Ghost can assist you. He is sent to help the church. He will teach you all things. He can direct your path from the place of battle, from the place of confusion. He can direct you because he is the way. Can show you the way. So Jesus is no longer here. And Jesus said, I am the way. And Jesus said, now the one who takes over from me is the Holy Ghost. And Jesus said, he will teach you all things. Now, why do you need the fellowship of the Holy Spirit? For he that speaketh in an unknown tongue, speaketh not unto men, but unto God, for no man understandeth him. Howbeit, in the Spirit he speaketh mysteries. We've come to the level that when we go into prayer, 99% of our prayer is not in English. It's not in vernacular. It's not in any language or tribe of this world. It's in the spirit. It's in tongues. As we speak in tongues, speak in tongues, speak in tongues, speak in the Holy Ghost. Why do we speak in tongues? He said, for no man understandeth him, including a spirit woman, or whether it's a demon, whether it's a man demon, whether it's a woman demon, they are not permitted to understand what we are speaking. Are you hearing me? He said, he that speaketh. He that speaketh in an unknown tongue speaketh not unto men but unto God. In other words, the direct telephone number to God is that means when there is a way to speak to God. He that speaketh in an unknown tongue. Speaketh not unto men, but unto God. For no man understandeth him. But how be it? The Spirit is speaketh mystery. If you are ordinary, you will be destroyed on time. You need to be a mysterious person. You can't be a mysterious person if you don't speak mystery. As you speak mystery, mysteries are supplied to you. Mysteries are being demystified. Are you hearing what I'm saying? David said, no wonder my life has become a wonder to so many. Your life become mysterious. People don't understand you. But there is something speaking for you. Somebody shout out here. And so there are many people in the church who are not enjoying what I'm talking about. They believe there are people, since they gave their life to Jesus, that is all they know. They have not graduated beyond that. If If you want to be an engineer,
si tu veux être un ingénieur,
you go through school, you are trained to become an engineer. But if you end up in primary school,
ingénieur,
you cannot become an engineer. You have to go from primary school. You have to go to secondary school. You have to either pass your jam or whatever. Then you come into university. And you, because you enter into university does not make you an engineer. No. There is a department you must go for. There are subjects you must pass. And then you go through the training.
L'entraînement
and pass it well, that makes you an engineer.
Engineer.
Acts chapter 19. There are Christians who are not powerful. They are prayerful. They pray, but they are not powerful. Because they are like this very Christian. And it came to pass that while Apollos was at Corinth, Paul, having passed through the upper coast, came to Ephesus, and finding certain disciples, he said unto them, have ye received the Holy Ghost since ye believed? Listen, they believed though. And they said unto him, we have not so much as heard whether there be any Holy Ghost. Can you imagine that? They are believers. So that means when you are speaking in tongues, they say, what is this one doing? Every time we'll be doing Rabakaya, what is he saying? We don't understand what he's doing. What is he talking about? We don't understand what they are talking about. Is this tongues they are speaking or what? He said, whether there be any Holy Ghost, we don't know. It's like somebody that bought a new car, you are driving it. You say, whether they are supposed to register it, you don't know. In fact, that is not even the right
description.
Now watch what happened. So there are people who don't know. They are only just to need and Father today, protect me. Give us food though, to manage, give us food. Oh Lord, protect us. Oh Lord, help us. That's all they know. Prayer is beyond God, give us food. Prayer is beyond God, give us money. In the place of prayer, many of us don't ask for money. No. We don't ask for things. We ask for things that prospers the kingdom. Why? Seek ye the kingdom of God first and his righteousness. He said unto them, have ye received the Holy Ghost since? Give me verse 3 now. And they said unto them, unto one then were ye baptized. And they said, unto John's baptism, which almost every one of you did. Some of you were baptized in the water. Some of you, even when you were 3 months old, they took you to the Orthodox church where you were born. They sprinkled water on your head. And you are baptized. I won't say anything about it. Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of the repentance, saying unto the people that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is on Christ Jesus. When they heard this, they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Give me verse 6. And when Paul had laid his hands upon them, the Holy Ghost came on them, and they spake with tongues and prophesied. You can't receive the Holy Ghost and not speak in tongues. They spake in tongues and they prophesied. Verse 7. Let me take only verse 7. And all the men were about 12. They speak in tongues and the prophesy. Now, these are people who would have received Jesus for years, believers, but no Holy Ghost. So it's a necessity that we fellowship with the Holy Spirit. Amen, somebody. So this is one of the reasons why we must pray, and pray where I pray in tongues. When I wake up at midnight to pray, I can take 45 minutes to 1 hour and give thanks to God. I have this on my phone that I attach to the speaker in my room. And it's worship. Worship after worship.
Adoration.
Sometimes I just lay before him and worship 45 minutes to 1 hour. Then after then I rise up. The rest is in tongues.
The rest.
Capital letter. Speak in capital letter tongues.
Parler en capital en langue.
After speaking in tongues, we say, Father, thank you for prayer answered. We have received everything we want to receive. Any communication, anything that is to be revealed, God has revealed. Then we go. There are people who believe, even though they speak in tongues, they get to some place. When we come as a church, it's good to pray. Apostle Paul said, though I speak in tongues, but yet I pray in understanding. In public places like this, yeah, we'll speak in tongues and still pray in understanding so that everybody can benefit, can become beneficial of everyone. But there are people who believe that unless they say, any power in my father's house, die by fire. Any wicked man that will not let me go, die. It's okay to die. But in the place of tongues, anybody that needs to die can still die. Why? Because the Holy Ghost is our prayer administrator. The Bible said, as we pray in tongues, as we pray in the spirit. He said, even when we know not what to pray for. Because sometimes you are confused, you are going through battles. As a person, you don't know where the battle is coming from. The Holy Ghost said, even when you know not what to pray for. He said, speak in the spirit, speak in tongues. He said, for the spirit helpeth our infirmity. That means your weakness of no understanding, the Holy Ghost helps it and amplifies it to become strength. Then as you speak in an unknown tongues, the Holy Spirit begins to direct your prayer because it's the prayer administrator, the one that needs to be refined. Because you know crude oil does not produce only fuel. In crude oil you have gas, you have diesel, you have different things in the same crude oil. In speaking in tongues, speaking in the Holy Ghost, we have prosperity, we have deliverance, are you hearing what I'm saying? So once you are speaking in the Holy Ghost, anyone that needs to die, the Holy Ghost settles it in tongues. We do not war by the flesh, for the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal, but the mighty through God to the pulling down of struggle. If there is a strong man visiting Abalis, visiting Juju, or a strong woman tormenting you through witchcraft, these are all spiritual matters. And it says the weapons of our warfare, they are not carnal. So if they are not carnal, that means I know what to do.
Ce n'est pas ordinaire en tant que chrétien.
Melem protos kiata. Ou disgi per embre evosata. Yanimalatosia. Le colabadia. Yendo pratosha. Zelivaratosia. Melokaba. Yanotasava. Erapatos. And kurapata. Do you know what happened when you do that for 1 hour? You know what happened when you do that for 2 hours? You know what happened when you do that for 3 hours? Do it for 4 hours. Do it. Ah! Yadarakataba! Let the Spirit come upon you in the name of Jesus. even know if I can take one or two more because of time. Number three, prayer is the authorized platform for growth and transformation. Prayer is the authorized platform for growth and transformation. That means if you want to grow today, begin to pray. If you want transformation, begin to do what? Pray. You know why you need to pray again and again? When a child is born, the mother or the parents, they keep feeding that child. Am I correct? Sometimes a mother can breastfeed a child more than 7-10 times a day. Am I correct? Why? Because you want the child to grow. So prayer is the authorized platform for growth and transformation of a believer. Somebody say, I hear you. 1 Corinthians chapter 14. Let's go back to the same 1 Corinthians 14. And verse number 4 this time. Quickly. Verse number 4. He that speaketh in an unknown tongue,
celui qui a parlé dans une langue inconnue,
edifieth himself.
Il est en train d'édifier.
He that speaketh in an unknown tongue,
a parlé en une langue inconnue,
edifieth himself.
Édifie.
But he that prophesieth edifieth the church.
Et celui qui.
So when I come here prophesying, I'm only helping people. I'm not helping myself. But in my place of prayer, when I speak in tongues for 6 hours, when I speak in tongues for 7 hours, when I speak in tongues for 8 hours, 9 hours, 10 hours, 11 hours, 12 hours, what am I doing?
I am. Je suis en train.
The word build. It's an architectural word. Verse 20 of Jude, let me show you something. He that speaketh in an unknown tongue edifieth himself. In other words, as you begin to pray in tongues, you are growing. As you begin in the spirit realm, we don't have size. We grow every day and we don't stop growing.
On ne cesse pas de prier, de grandir plutôt.
He said, but yet, beloved, building up yourselves on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. So every time the karabako tayaba, you are growing. You are growing your destiny. You are growing your future. You are making your way brighter. The path of the righteous is like a shining light.
La puissance du juste est comme une lumière qui brille.
That shineth brighter and brighter. It doesn't just shine brighter and brighter because you are a child of God. It shines because you are a praying child of God. There is a part of the believer that makes the light shine. You will never work in darkness anymore. I can hear your amen. Give me Luke chapter number 9.
Luke chapter 4.
Luke 9 verse 28, 29. So when you pray, it brings growth. It brings transformation.
Ça met la transformation.
Luke chapter 9 verse 28. And it came to pass. About an 8 days after these sayings, he took Peter and John and James and went up into a mountain to pray. 29. And as he prayed, the fashion of his countenance was altered, and his raiment was white and glistering. They went to the place of prayer, door. But as they were praying, the Bible said, and as he prayed, the fashion of his countenance was altered.
La façon de leur.
And his raiment was white and glistering. In other words, prayer brings about transformation. This is not the only time. Remember, the Bible said when Moses went to pray, And he was in the mountain with God for about 40 days and 40 nights. The Bible said when Moses came back, that the people could not look at him. Because the prayer has altered the fashion of Moses. The people could not look at him. Moses had to put veil, he had to veil his face to talk to the people. Complete mask.
La masque complète.
He masked himself.
C'est masqué.
Because the glory was so much.
Parce que la gloire était trop.
Do you know when the sun is much? Like, oui. I mean, scorching sun. You know you can't look at it. So, Moses came, the glory was too much.
Oui, c'est venu la gloire.
In such fashion. So, prayer.
Alors, la prière.
Their countenance was altered. That means, listen, when you get to the realm of prayer, and you live in the realm of prayer, people will see you and they say, there is something about this woman. There is something about this man. There is a glory. You carry a presence. You don't announce the presence of a man of prayer. The presence announces itself.
La présence s'annonce.
Receive the same glory in the name of Jesus. As you pray, the glory will speak for you. Number four, why do we need prayer? Why we must pray? We must pray for warfare,
la guerre,
and intercession.
Et l'intercession.
1 John chapter 5, verse 19. It said, the whole world lies in wickedness. Now, brothers, sisters, listen. How do you escape the world full of wickedness if you are not praying?
Si vous ne priez pas, comment échapper?
You are not planning evil for somebody, but people are planning your downfall.
Ne planifie pas le mal de quelqu'un, mais les gens planifient votre mal.
It could even be somebody you trust so much. David said, if it were to be an enemy, I would have endured it. He said, but it's you. The world is full of wickedness. Your family, they are chasing you.
Famille vous poursuivre.
People who expect so much from you and you are not able, they don't even know that you are going through your own battle. You are trying to sort out, but you are just, the glory of God is what is covering you. They are fighting you in their mind, saying, look at him, very selfish.
Regardez, il est très égoïste.
Some are setting trap for you.
Il y en a qui mettent les...
Some are asking, when will you be finished?
Les autres se demandent, quand tu vas être fini?
In Acts of Apostles, the Bible said 40 men, about 40 men, they rose up and said they will not eat nor drink until they eliminate Paul the apostle. Paul was not even aware. Do you know how many people that are planning for your destruction?
Paul était pas au courant. Vous savez combien de personnes planifient votre destruction?
Do you know how many people?
Vous savez les gens qui...
Do you know how many altars? Do you know how many powers? Do you know how many demonic influence going on?
Combien d'influences démoniaques en cours?
From powers against you,
destruction,
that you're not even aware of,
des puissances contre vous que vous n'êtes pas au courant.
And then you are like somebody walking. Watch what David said. David understands this. He said, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, every day we are walking through the valley of the shadow of death.
Chaque fois nous marchons à travers les vallées de la mort.
The sun shall not smite thee by day, neither the moon by night. We are either walking under the sun or under the moon.
Dans le jour.
Arrows are flying every now and then.
Les flèches volent de gauche à
droite. Arrows of sickness, arrows of poverty, arrows of affliction, arrows to cause disaffection in your family, in your marriage, in your home.
Dans vos maisons, dans vos mariages, dans vos maisons.
And you are keeping quiet.
Vous êtes silencieux.
Something is going wrong with your son. You are trying to use science to explain what is going wrong with your son.
La science pour expliquer.
Your husband all of a sudden is behaving in a strange way. You are trying to explain, I don't know why my husband shut up.
Je suis en train d'expliquer, il sait pas comment mon mari ceci cela. Et toi.
Go and pray.
Va prier.
For warfare.
La guerre.
This world is wicked.
Le monde, ce monde est méchant.
A lady was planning wedding.
Une fille planifiait le mariage.
I met with the mother of this lady.
J'ai rencontré la mère de cette fille.
And her best friend.
Et son ancien.
Poisoned her.
L'a empoisonné.
Because the best friend is jealous of the kind of man she is to marry.
Parce que le.
And the best friend wanted the same man. And the best friend poisoned.
Tout sa meilleure amie.
She died.
Sa meilleure amie l'a empoisonné parce que elle était jalouse.
Took her to the hospital.
Le genre de mari.
Hospital could not help her.
Mais
but you know what prayer does?
Marie.
Why prayer? Why warfare is necessary? Why prayer is a protocol? There are people that all of a sudden you think they are your best friend, but quarrel broke out, and two of you could not reconcile, and you are forgiving the person. It's not because of you. It's the danger the person will pose to you, and God saw the danger coming, but from the place of prayer, prayer went to arrange the person. So, are you hearing me? So that the person will not stand as a threat against you. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes,
as you begin to pray today, as we declare prayer of warfare,
yes,
that man or woman who is supposed to kill you, before the time will come, there is going to be a war that the person will not be able to assess you. If you are hearing me, somebody say, talk to me. That lady was a person of prayer. What would happen? Maybe 3 months before that time. Either God will expose her, or what, God will put confusion that she will not want to see the person again. God wants to carry you through a season. In certain moments, there are certain people God will shake away from your life. Because you don't understand. The Bible said we know in part, but in the place of prayer, the Holy Ghost, who sees and knows and understands everything, in the place of prayer goes ahead of you and protocols things for you. He looked at the one that is supposed to poison you, the one that is supposed to betray you. He turns them away from your life. Hear me, some people will go out of your life because you are praying now. Some of them are going to walk out of you. Not because you are a bad person or they are bad people, but there is something God is saving you out from before the time will manifest. Is anybody hearing me?
Yes, sir.
The prayer for today will deliver you from the battle of tomorrow. Somebody say, talk to me.
Talk to me.
Sit down, let us pray. James 5 from verse number 13. Then after that, give me Acts of Apostles chapter 1. Chapter 12 from verse 1. Is any among you afflicted? Let him pray. Is any merry? Now there are afflictions you are going through that are demonic and man-made. And he said, are you going through this kind of warfare of affliction? He said, the cure, the biblical cure for affliction is prayer. Don't try to explain affliction. I've been taking treatment too. I've been trying my best to. No. Don't try it next time. Pray.
Faut prier.
That joblessness is affliction. That disappointment is affliction.
Déception, c'est l'affliction.
You have tried to put everything right on your own as a man, as a woman, but the situation keep repeating. Then he said, is there any among you afflicted? Let him pray. Is any merry? Let him sing psalms. Verse 14. Is any sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church and let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he have committed sins, they shall be forgiven him. So you know, in the place of prayer, we have power. that even the power of sins don't stand the power of prayer.
La puissance de péché.
That as we pray, even if someone have committed sin, now in the place of prayer puts us in the place, in the position of God himself, because prayer is communication between humanity and divinity. Now every time a man prays, prayer is what brings God to the scene. Now when God comes to the scene, he resides in a man, and when God stays in a man, that man has the same power that God has. He said, if any have sinned, their sins shall be forgiven. Not because God forgave them, but because a man of prayer says your sins are forgiven. Anyone here that have sinned, as a man of prayer, your sins are forgiven.
Amen.
Then he said, confess your fault one to another. So a man who prays for you, who has spiritual power to bless you, you lie before that man, you die. You might not physically die, but you can begin to suffer affliction under grace. You can begin to suffer setback under grace. And Ananias and Sapphira, they did that with a man who is their spiritual father. The worst thing that can happen to you is to lie before your spiritual father. He might not immediately rebuke you. He might keep you quiet. And God might cause him to keep you quiet. But you know what you put yourself? You expose yourself to attack. You expose yourself, because when you lie to a man, you are under his grace. You take yourself out of the grace. Then that's why I said, when you go to such elders, he said, confess your fault one to another and pray for one another that ye may be healed. He said, the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. Effectual, fervent, effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. He said, Elias was a man subject to like passion as we are, and he prayed. In other words, listen carefully, let me explain. Yes. Elijah was a man. The same feelings you carry about Elisha, carry it about. And the way many of you, your adrenaline is pumping, his own is pumping like that too. But he oppressed it and still prayed. The way you can verse into the verse.
It was his nerve.
Okay, let me explain it better, the way you understand. Let me have verse 17 in Amplified. So nothing should stop you from praying. Because one of the things the enemy wants you to do, the enemy wants to push you to a place that you will feel so much guilty in the presence of your God, and you are not, you are unable to pray. Because the enemy brings you to the place of guilt so that you lose the place of prayer. It brings you to the place of guilt. Because you know many times you want to pray, and the enemy is telling you, you that just did this mistake, you that just did that mistake, then you end up not praying. You are still nursing guilt for years. But the Bible says, where there is sin, grace abounds. But that does not give you right. He said, even if you make mistake, you can still go back to your father. Okay, hold on. He said, Elijah was a man with a nature. A man with what? So I'm bringing it to your everyday life. A man with a what? A nature. Like yours. That sometimes your nature wants to misbehave. And put it on that hold. He said, Elijah was a man with a nature like ours, with the same physical, mental, and spiritual limitations and shortcomings. Not a man without mistake. As a matter of fact, the day will become 100% perfect. I'm not perfect. You know why I'm not perfect? The day I become perfect, the supply of help from the Spirit will cease. The Spirit helpeth our infirmity. So watch what he says. Elijah was a man with a nature like us, with the same physical, mental, and spiritual limitations and shortcomings. And he prayed intensely for it not to rain, and it did not rain on the earth for 3 years and 6 months with all these complications. What is stopping you from praying?
Quand vous arrêtez de prier.
What is stopping you from praying?
Qu'est-ce qui vous arrête de prier?
Because the enemy is warring against your members and he doesn't want you to pray. So every time you want to pray, he reminds you that you made one mistake.
Tu as fait une erreur.
Maybe a mistake you made 3 months ago, 6 months ago, 3 years ago. He brings it before you. Let me help you.
Qui vous aide?
Remind the devil
for rappeler au diable
that Jesus paid the price on the cross of Calvary.
Jésus a payé le prix sur la croix de Calvaire.
And they declare that it is finished.
C'est fini.
And remind him that Jesus is your advocate. That the Holy Spirit is interceding for you.
Jésus est votre avocat. Il est là pour vous.
He prayed.
Il a prié.
And the Bible said it did not rain. Okay, give me the same translation from the Message translation. He went a bit further. Watch this with me, quickly. He said, Elijah, for instance, human, just like us, prayed hard that it wouldn't rain, and it didn't. Not a drop. For how long? Look at, you know, this one makes it look so ordinary, while the other one, in the art of explanatory, more powerful. This one is a human, just, that means he's just a human, like I and you. But the difference between him and you is the secret place of prayer. He that dwelleth in the secret place of prayer.
Reste dans les places secrètes de Dieu, des prières plutôt.
Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
So that is where you pray.
Là, vous allez prier.
You pray, and God turns your battle.
Le Seigneur tourne votre bataille.
It was a man like you. So begin to pray from today.
Prier à partir d'aujourd'hui.
The reason why you are here in Grace Nation is because God wants to use you to break your family out from the powers that refuse to let them go. We are not just prophesying on you, we are impacting on you. We are releasing grace on you. Every time you come here, what I'm doing is I'm imparting something to you. I'm sowing a seed into you. I am transferring what God gave me to you, that the same advantage I have, you will have. The same victory I have, you will have. The same way I conquer, you will conquer. Are you hearing me, somebody?
Yes, sir.
So when you go back, tell them I am here to help you. That's why you came. I am empowering you so that you will go and empower your family. Your family should not be in bondage anymore. Declare prayer. Show them the place of prayer. The Bible says you shall declare a thing and they shall come to pass. Are we still together? Somebody said, talk to me.
Talk to me.
Okay, give me Acts chapter 12 quickly from verse 1. Quickly. Acts 12. Then after then, give me Genesis 28. Acts 12 from 1. Now, about that time, Herod the king stretched forth his hand to verse certain of the church. Remember? And 2, quickly. And he killed James, the brother of John, with a sword. Uh-huh. Listen, if you are not praying, they will kill you.
Si vous ne priez pas, ils vont vous tuer.
James is a believer, an apostle.
Jacques,
they cut his head. I want you to see that. And because he saw it pleased the Jews, he proceeded further to take Peter also. Then were the days of unleavened bread. I want you to see that enemies can kill you for fun.
Les ennemis peuvent vous tuer pour l'amusement.
The Bible said he saw that it pleased the people. So that's fun. So let me bring Peter. I killed Peter for fun. And when he had apprehended him, he put him in prison and delivered him to four quaternions of soldiers to keep him, intending after Easter to bring him forth to the people. Peter therefore was kept in prison, but prayer was made without ceasing of the church unto God for him. Prayer was made without ceasing unto God by the church for him. And when Herod would have brought him forth, the same night Peter was sleeping between two soldiers, bound with two chains, and the keepers before the door kept the prison. And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and the light shined in the prison, and they smote Peter on the side and raised him up, saying, "Arise up quickly." And his chains fell off from his hands. The prayer they were praying in the church went into the prison with an angelic response. Then chains in the hands of Peter fell. Today, by the power of the Holy Ghost, anywhere they chain you, the chain is falling off. Your relative, your family, your loved one, whether chain of sickness, whether chain of affliction, that chain is falling off. Died. Peter lived. James died because there was no prayer. But when they took Peter, the Bible said the church began to pray without ceasing. As they were praying, an angel came as a response to their prayer. And Peter was released from the prison. Peter was released. Every time you pray, chains falls off from you. I command the chains that limited you in prison, the chain that limited you, limited your finances, limited your family, limited your children, limited your brothers, that limited your sisters, that limited your father, by the power of the Holy Ghost, from the place of prayer, I command the chain to fall. I command the chain to break. Somebody shout fire. Lift up your legs, shout fire. Shout fire. You are breaking out, breaking forth, and breaking through. Musalata baragaliyaba, lokoto sabiata radabadaba, marabada yaba. Genesis 28. Zobalakata yaba. Begin to pray from today. Don't go back home and keep quiet. It's a command, you must pray. It's a necessity. Pray whether you feel like praying. Pray whether you feel good. Pray whether you are not feeling good. Pray whether you prosper. Pray whether you are not prospering. If business goes well, pray. It doesn't go well, pray. Don't stop praying. Verse 12. Quickly, give me verse 12.
Genèse 28.
And they dreamed, and behold, a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, the angels of God ascending and descending on it. You know what? You know I'm reading this place?
Vous savez pourquoi je lis cette place?
Listen. The Bible said these are angels ascending and descending. Is that correct? Now, do you know? Listen to this carefully. Whilst the church was praying, an angel came to heaven. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, for the fact you are not aware, angels are helping people every day. Every day. The Bible said the eyes of Jacob was open. He saw angels descending and ascending. But none of the angels were coming to help them, because he's ignorant about the angelic activities. He's ignorant about angelic ministry. A man who prays understands angelic activities. So it's possible that other people are enjoying divine intervention, you are not enjoying it. Jacob only saw them, but he didn't see the angels helping them. So what God literally showed Jacob, that angels still helps people till today. angels are still helping people. There are still angelic activities going on. But you can't enjoy it. It was then he woke up and his attitude changed. His understanding. And they began to go to the secret place. Somebody shout a big amen.
Amen.
Number five, prayer is a strategy to keep your faith alive. Prayer is a strategy to keep your faith alive. Luke 22, verse 30. Luke 22, verse 30 and 31. Quickly, I'm going to be very brief. Prayer is a strategy to keep your faith alive. That ye may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom and sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. 31. And the Lord says, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan had desired to have you, that ye, that he may sift you as what? As wheat. But if you go forward, there is something Jesus said to him. Jesus said, go. In the place of prayer, you have been strengthened.
Dans la place de prière, vous êtes renforcé.
Now that your faith is strengthened, go and strengthen the faith of others. So prayer strengthens our faith. Do you know, if you used to have fear, you get to a certain level of prayer that you don't fear anymore. That's what prayer does. You pray and pray that nothing, you are not afraid of anything. That even little thing, you jump up like this. No, you get to the level. Whether physical or spiritual, you are not afraid of it. That's what prayer does. And number six, prayer is a platform to make requests or petition. Prayer is a platform to make requests or petition. Mark chapter 11. Verse 22, Mark chapter 11. So you can't make petition until you come to the platform of prayer. David said, I will enter into his gate with thanksgiving in my heart, and I will enter into his court with what? With what? With what? With praise. 22 to 24. And Jesus answered, said unto them, have faith in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou moved, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said. Therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire when ye pray, believe ye that ye receive them, and ye shall have them. So the only place where we can make petition and receive is in the platform.
La plateforme.
Of prayer. I can hear you.
Je n'entends pas.
It's in the platform of prayer. Elijah received rain. Elijah shut down a whole nation in the place of prayer. He opened the nation via the platform of prayer. Anna was barren for years. She opened it up from the place of prayer. Is anybody hearing me? Hezekiah was to die. He went to the platform of prayer himself. And God by himself, who says my words that I speak can never return back to me void. But in the place of prayer, the word was voided. That doesn't mean that what God speaks is lie. He says the word that I speak will not return to me. Until has accomplished his purpose. Then a man prayed. God gave a word to a prophet, and the man went to God in the place of prayer. He said, remember everything I've done. Remember the souls I've won. God, I know your word is final, but in this situation, change the word. And God said, but you know, I have integrity. What will people say? He said, no. Tell them I said it. Tell them I've withdrawn it. Tell them that this is what I used to replace what I said before. Said 15 years. I don't know what has been spoken on your life. Anyone that is negative that does not favor you, coming from the place of prayer,
I call for heaven to withdraw it. Let the one that will favor you be released. Philippians chapter 4. Philippians give it to me quickly. Philippians 4 Philippians from verse 6 to 7. Quickly. Philippians 4, 6 to 7. Be fast. Philippians 4, 6 to 7. Thank you, Jesus. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Go back to verses. I want everybody to read it with me together. One to go. Be careful for nothing. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. By prayer and supplication, that is where you present your request, and also in thanksgiving. James chapter 4.
Jacques, chapter 4.
I mean, some people still pray, they don't even understand the power of prayer. From whence comes wars and fightings among you? Come there not hence, even of your lust, that war in your members? Because sometimes we pray, and the prayer we pray does not reflect the kingdom.
La prière que nous faisons ne reflète pas dans le royaume des cieux.
If your request must go to God, let your request reflect the kingdom.
Laisse qu'elle reflète dans le royaume.
Without the kingdom, you are asking me to give you this. If I give you this thing you are asking, what will it benefit me?
Qu'est-ce qui va me bénéficier?
Everything in the spirit is transactional.
Tout ce qui est en esprit, c'est la transaction.
God loved the world, he gave.
Dieu aime le monde.
Why did he give?
Pourquoi l'a donné?
It's not just the love. Love is the propeller.
L'amour.
But why? What after the love?
Après l'amour.
What else? Is to reap me and you.
C'est pour vous, me récolter, vous et moi.
To the kingdom to become useful.
Le royaume, pour que le royaume devienne utile.
Now when you say, God, I want to marry.
Le Seigneur, je veux vous marier.
When you say, God, give me a husband. God, give me a car. God, give me a job. In this request, is God represent? Is the kingdom of God represented in it? Hold on, I want to show you what I'm talking about. From whence come wars and fightings among you? Come there not hence, even of your lust, that war in your members? So many of you, the Bible is saying, you go to God in prayer because of your lusts. Another translation says, as a result of your hedonistic desires, selfishness. God, give me this car so that when I go to my village this Christmas, people will know that I've arrived. Where is God in that thing you are talking about? If you go by Kennedy Lichuku, we then know that you have arrived. If you go by Chisco, we then know that you have arrived. If you follow the young shall grow, we don't know that you have arrived. Kind rubbish prayer. Lord, give me a car this year that they may know, God, that they may know I've arrived. That's your request. Where is the kingdom represented?
About the man, where the royaume represented là?
He said, for your lusts. Every time your request goes to the altar and the kingdom is not involved, consider the request. Is struck out. See this. He said, yea, lost and have not. Yea, kill and desire to have and cannot obtain. Yea, fight and war, yet have not, because ye ask not. Now, even when you ask, verse 3.
Matthew the Monday.
Yea, ask and receive not, because ye ask amiss, that ye may consume it upon your lusts. Give me amplified in the verse 3. Give me amplified in on your lust. I want to marry a rich man. The rich man is not that you will sponsor the kingdom of God.
The rich man
so that you begin to drive big cars. You begin to dress well.
Exactly.
There is no problem with that. But the question is that where is the kingdom represented in this request?
Did the Bible not say? The scriptures cannot be broken. We must follow the principle of prayer for us to get our prayers answered. He said, you ask God for something and do not receive it because you ask with wrong motives. Out of selfishness or with an unrighteous agenda. So that when you get what you want, you may spend it on your hedonistic desires, on your lust. Some of you are praying for God to prosper. When He prospers, you will leave your wife and start harassing young girls.
Vous allez laisser votre femme et commencer à poursuivre les jeunes filles.
How does God answer that kind of prayer?
Comment le Seigneur va répondre à ces prières?
You start disrespecting your wife.
Vous commencez à ne pas respecter votre femme.
Everywhere you see young ladies, you are harassing, assaulting them. You cannot get promotion until you sleep with her. Where is God represented then? But if you change the request like this, God, I come to church every day. And I'm coming from a very far distance. I don't have a car. But God, there are souls I've won in my area. If you give me this car, I want to use it to bring more people to your kingdom every day and to aid evangelism. Lord, that's why I'm asking you for this car. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I don't know if you get what I'm saying. Because we need to understand why you pray, you don't get answer. You say, God, give me a house. I've been in Lagos for 20 years now, no house. If you like, you die in Lagos, you can't get. But it concerns God for how many years you don't stay
there. You say,
God, the way other people are doing house fellowship, Lord, please, I want to bring the Ark of Covenant into my house. Give me a house. The first thing I would dedicate to you is a place of fellowship for you to win souls. You must know how to come before Him. Platform on how to get these things. It's very important. God, I want a husband. God, I want a husband. I want a God-fearing husband because I want to serve you as never before. I want to serve you with my husband because your word said two are better than one. If I'm winning 10 people, I want my husband to join me so that we can be winning 20 people. If I was giving 5,000 or 10,000 as partnership, I want to bring a man that would join me so that it can become 50,000. Lord, give me that man. And God said, wow, my kingdom is represented in their affairs and their agenda. I come in. That's how you bring God in. God bless my business. Only you the tithe, your business not the tithe. How many of you, devourer can harass your business anyhow? You say, God, I want you to increase this business so that I can increase my partnership. God, I want you to bless me. I have never sponsored a crusade before. I want to sponsor a crusade. God, give me this contract. If you give me this contract, inside this contract, I'm going to sponsor 10 crusades. I'm going to sponsor 5 crusades. I'm going to give a bus to the church for evangelism, for aggressive soul winning. Watch God. Show up and do something. I'm showing you how to get your prayers answered easily. I told you that I've never one day gone to God in prayer and say, God, give us money, God prosper us. When I go to God in prayer, in speaking in tongues, is to deploy power to advance the cause of the kingdom, to deploy power, to deploy grace, to deploy His presence, to depopulate the kingdom of darkness, and to set the captive free. Is this not all about God's kingdom? Then He says, seek my kingdom first and the rest shall be added. That's how I know that I can never be broke. I cannot be poor. Is God talking to somebody here? Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
Last, then we'll pray. Prayer brings God to the scene. Open your Bible, everybody. Acts chapter 4.
Acts chapter 4.
Open it. Verse 31.
Verse 31.
Prayer brings God to where? That means it's prayer that makes God manifest here. No. Action. The Bible said, and when they had prayed, the place was shaking when they were assembled together. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. And they spake the word of God with boldness. That means as they prayed, God showed up. Stand to your feet, everybody. From today, God will show up in your life.
Amen.
As you pray, God will show up in your business.
Amen.
When you are praying to God, God is speaking to something on your behalf. Prayer brings God to the scene. The things that cannot listen to you, they listen to God. He said the hour is coming when even the dead will hear the voice of God and they will come back to life. The dead does not hear the voice of a man, the dead hear the voice of God. That's why Jesus prayed. It is in the place of prayer that this baptism of hear him will come. People who don't understand prayer are the ones who go on their knees. I mean, who go about begging people for everything. One senator has become your God. One CEO has become your God. One bank director has become your God. For 2 years, they are promising you. Okay, bring down your CV again. You take the CV, you give them the CV. Just as you go, they squeeze it. They trash it. Leave the man.
Let's sit on.
Go to the one who can manipulate the man. Esther said, I know I can't just go to the king, but let all of us pray for 3 days. Then after the prayer, I will go before the king. If I perish, I perish. Prayer gives you some strange boldness and brings God to the scene. The Bible said when they had prayed, Esther went there. The prayer was still on. The Bible said the king could not sleep because somebody had to be helped. Now, imagine. This man, Mordecai, tried to lobby. Oh, how can he even enter the palace of the king? How can?
Come on.
But in the place of prayer, when we have demonic manipulation, we have better divine manipulation. As he was praying, God, I know I cannot go to this king, but I know that the heart of the king is in your heart. You turn it to wherever you please. As he was praying, God went to the palace of the king and said, somebody is disturbing me. King, I come to disturb you to help somebody. The Bible said that night the king could not sleep. Do you know what will happen as you go to that place of prayer and get God in prayer for hours? As you pray, you say, God, I don't know anybody in this Lagos. I heard that in Nigeria that if you don't know anybody, you cannot be connected. God, I don't have any connection. You are the connection I know. You are the only connection I know. I don't know any senator. I don't know any bank CEO. I don't know any director anywhere. I don't know have anybody that I would give. I have nobody that I would give to any man to sleep with. I only have you. God, you are the one that commands and controls the affairs of men. Lord, command a man to look for me. Lord, command a man to help me. You can be in your backyard, somebody, a big man will drive his expensive car. Convoy, they will come and look for you. Are you so person? Is it true that you can do this? You say yes, that's all. Whether that same man that has been trashing your CV. Go to prayer. If God will not enter his house, enter his wife. And the wife will say, what of that our that boy that has been coming to you for job? The man said, it's true. Please, where is his number? They will call you. God can manipulate things in your life.